equivalent diagram, and I will so I am giving the restriction. So first is the, that iron. I will the melting. First is the iron. The melting point of iron is a 5039 degree centigrade. First, before explaining iron carbon equivalent diagram, I want to explain that what is iron and what is type of iron and what is the steel and how, what is type of steel. So first start from that from iron. So melting point of iron is 5039 degree centigrade. And I want to before explaining iron and steel, I want to know the property of carbon, which is widely used in the further application. If we increase the percentage of carbon in iron, so percentage of carbon increase, so brittleness will increase. If we brittleness will increase and ductility will be reduced. Ductility will be reduced. So ductility will be reduced. So material will be very soft. This is a very important property of iron, and we can directly tell with that which iron is the more ductile or which iron is the more brittle. And is in exam directly question come which iron is the more ductile as compared to other, or we can tell. So now I am so if the percentage of carbon is less than 2%, then it's called the steel. If percentage of carbon in iron is less than 2%, it's called steel, and if percentage of carbon is more than 2%, it's called the cast iron. So I will explain first steel and then after the iron. So steel. So I have classified steel in the two types. First is the type of percentage of carbon, and second is the type of oxidation. So type of carbon, percentage of carbon, there are three types of steel. First one is the mild steel. Second one is the medium carbon steel. Third one is the tool steel. This is also called as the high carbon steel. In mild steel, percentage of carbon is less than 2%. Less than 2%. In the medium carbon steel, when the percentage of carbon is less than 0.75 and more than 0.25%. And when the percentage of carbon is less than 0.55%, it's called the tool steel. So what is the application of these steel? Mild steel is used in the structural product. Suppose if you want to make car structure, this is made by the mild steel. If you want to airframe frame of an aeroplane, this is made by the mild steel. And medium carbon steel, all the movable products are made by the medium carbon steel. Suppose if you want to make the camshaft, crankshaft, a gear, all the products are made by the medium carbon steel. And the tool steel, all the tool products are made by tool steel. Suppose chisels, saw, and or the hammer are the, made by the tool steel. And type of the oxidation, there are three type of steel. First is oxidized steel. In which steel there is oxygen present, this is called the oxidized steel. Deoxidized steel, when no oxygen present, is called the deoxidized steel. And ring steel, when partially oxidized and partially deoxidized steel, is called the ring steel. Second one, type of iron. First, pig iron. Pig iron, basic form of iron which is available from any furnace is called the pig iron. And the second one is called white cast iron. White cast iron, cast iron. And if we the iron which is if pig iron, if you melt and cool fast, very fastly, then it is called the white cast iron. And if you cool slowly, then it's called the grey cast iron. So there is a difference between white cast iron and grey cast iron. If you cool the iron very fastly, then structure then it outer surface will be cool and it will form with the brittle structure. That is called, and this iron is called the white cast iron. And if you cool slowly and close slowly, then it will form the grey cast iron. In grey cast iron, the structure is a laminar. So the ductility structure is a laminar. So the ductility will be more in grey cast iron. And the third one is the malleable cast iron. Malleable cast iron. This is a basically white cast iron, and it is made from the white cast iron. And all the movable products are made by the malleable cast iron. Suppose the camshaft, crankshaft, gear are made by the white cast iron. And third one is the nodular cast iron. Fourth one is the nodular cast iron. So nodular cast iron, it is a it is made by the gray cast iron. And in nodular cast iron, the structure are in the form of spherical. So the machinability will be very easy, as machine will be very easy, because spherical shapes are more machinable than other shape. And third one is the wrought iron. It is a very important type of iron, because in wrought iron the percentage of carbon is even less than steel. In wrought iron percentage of carbon is 0.2 to 0.03%, and it is less than steel. In wrought iron the carbon in the form of the in fibers. That's why it is very useful in the forming operation, because iron is in form of fiber, so it can be very easily reproduced in any shape, and that's why it is used in the forming operation. So now from now I will explain the iron carbon equivalent diagram. So before explaining iron carbon equivalent diagram, I will explain the different type of iron which will be used in iron carbon equivalent diagram. So in iron carbon we use a ferrite iron. Ferrite iron is basically ferrite iron, maximum percentage of carbon is 0.2%, and second is austenite, maximum percentage of carbon is 2%, and third one is delta iron, maximum percentage of carbon is equal to 0.08%. So I in earlier I have explained that if the percentage of carbon is increases, so ductility will be reduced. Ductility will be reduced in the starting, I have explained, and brittleness will be increased. So I can directly say that which is the more ductile and soft as compared to others. So percentage of carbon in the ferrite is less as compared to austenite. So ferrite is more ductile as compared to austenite. And the structure of ferrite is a BCC. Room term, in exam question comes to there, which is the available room temperature iron. This is called the ferrite, and the structure is a BCC type. And austenite structure is a FCC. And delta iron, the structure is distorted BCC. So now I will explain that different type of a reaction which is occurring in iron carbon equilibrium diagram. So first reaction is a eutectic reaction. Percentage of carbon is 4.3%. In eutectic reaction, actually jo liquid convert into austenite iron and plus cementite. In eutectic reaction, liquid convert into austenite plus cementite. And the second reaction is a eutectile reaction. The percentage of carbon is 0.8%. In eutectile reaction, the austenite is converted into PLi, ferrite plus cementite. And third point is a peritictic reaction. Peritictic reaction, delta iron plus liquid iron converted into austenite. So these are the three reactions which is occurring in the iron carbon equilibrium diagram, and this mixture is called a ledoverite. In exam directly comes question, which is called ledoverite. So austenite plus cementite mixture is called the ledoverite, and this mixture is called a pearlite. So these are the three reactions which will occur in iron carbon equilibrium diagram. I have a prepared iron carbon equilibrium diagram. मैंने पहले ही प्रिपेयर कर रखा है, बिकॉज देयर इज अ लिमिटेशन इन टाइम. सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट इजी टू ड्रॉ द आयरन कार्बन डायग्राम विद इन 15 मिनट्स एंड टू एक्सप्लेन ऑल द थिंग्स. सो फर्स्ट रिएक्शन आई हैव टेल्ड दैट यूटेक्टिक रिएक्शन, द परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन इज 4.3%. दिस इज द टेम्परेचर एंड परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन डायग्राम. When the percentage of carbon, this is 2%, and when the percentage of carbon is less than 2%, this is called the steel, and when percentage of carbon is more than 2%, this is called the cast iron. So first point is the eutectic reaction. In eutectic reaction, percentage of carbon is 4.3%, here 4.3% carbon, and this point is called the eutectic reaction. In eutectic reaction, liquid converts into austenite plus cementite. This point is a eutectic point. Here is a liquid. First, I will explain that how this diagram is made. I want to explain how this diagram is made. This is the melting point of 1539 degrees. This is a liquid metal. If you melt the iron, this liquid will form. So this is the delta form of iron. So liquid and delta form तो दिस रीजन विल कम लिक्विड प्लस डेल्टा, दिस इज द एस्टरनाइट फॉर्म ऑफ आयरन, सो एंड हियर इज अ लिक्विड, सो दिस रीजन विल बी लिक्विड एंड डेल्टा, दिस इज लिक्विड फॉर्म and this is a eutectic point. In eutectic point, liquid constitutes austenite plus cementite. So here, liquid form, this is a eutectic point. So this point, liquid converted into liquid plus cementite. So here will be gamma plus cementite. Here will be gamma plus cementite. But before eutectic point, the percentage of austenite is more. So here is gamma plus ledoborite. And after the eutectic point, percentage of cementite is more. So cementite plus ledoborite. Actually, the ledoborite is the gamma plus cementite. So liquid is converted to ledoborite. We have directly written liquid is converted to ledoborite. Liquid is converted to ledoborite. But here, how gamma comes? Because before 4.3, austenite is more. So austenite plus ledoborite. And after the cementite is more, so cementite plus ledoborite. So these are reasons are completed, and the second reaction is the eutectic reaction. In eutectic reaction, this is a gamma austenite. So in eutectic reaction, gamma converted into ferrite plus cementite. This is called the pyrite. So this is a eutectic point below this pyrite, and this is called pyrite. So how alpha is written? Because before the eutectoid point, alpha is a more so. Because it's alpha, so C is alpha plus pyrite, and after the eutectoid point, cementite is more, so pyrite plus cementite. The third one reaction is a peritic reaction. Here the delta plus liquid converted to gamma. So this is called the delta iron, this is called the liquid iron. So this is called the eutectoid point. So after this will form the gamma iron. And very important question which comes in exam, that hypotructidistal and hyperutructidistal. So this is called a eutectic point. Before eutectic point, if the question asks if the percentage of carbon is less than 4.3% and more than 2%, then which type of steel is formed? This is called a hypo. If the less than 4.3% is called the hypo. If the more than 4.3% is called the hyper. So this is called the hypo-eutectic steel. And the percentage of carbon is more than 4.3%. This is called the hyper-eutectic steel. And the second question is the this is called the eutectoid point. If the percentage of carbon is less than 0.8%, this is called the hypo-eutectoid steel. And if the percentage of carbon is more than 0.8% and less than 2%, is called the hyper eutectoid steel. So this is the iron carbon program. Now I will explain that if you melt the iron carbon and we cool the iron, then what will happen? At room temperature, this is 539 degree centigrade, and this is a liquid. If you cool the iron carbon, and between 530 and we reach 394 degree centigrade, then there is a phase occur, and after this is called delta iron. Because if you cool and at 394 degree centigrade there is a phase transformation occur, and after that if you cool the liquid iron, and then it will form the delta iron, and then after that we further cool, this will form the gamma iron, and we after that 910 degree centigrade we cool, this will form the alpha iron and below 9-10 degree centigrade. 90 degree centigrade, it will also form the alpha iron. But in the, there is a difference between these two. This is called this is paramagnetic iron and this is ferromagnetic alpha iron. So I think that time limit has crossed. So I want to complete my presentation. Thank you, sir.